Happy Christmas! It's Christmas Day and welcome to the virtual village. Now, Buddy and Joy are still in their pajamas, but it is Christmas Day and I told them you wouldn't mind. Come on, guys, come on! In your pajamas! They've been so busy opening all of their presents.
Did you have a lovely Christmas?
Yeah, I hope you guys have had too. We've got a Christmas special virtual village for you today. We've got hashtag jokes, worship with Esther, and a very special Christmas Day edition of the Gospel Show with Elisha and Abigail.
I've got a busy day today. Who's this one for?
Ooh, Mary.
25 Christmas Roll.
This is it. 25 Christmas Roll. Are you Mary?
Yes. Thanks for the package.
You're welcome.
What's this?
Jokes, welcome back to Heavenly News. This just in, Mary has been chosen to give birth to the Son of God. I know it's hard to believe, Mary, but this means you're going to be a celebrity for years to come. In fact, today, children all over the world are dressing up as you in nativities. Here's some going down the red carpet.
Wow, I can't believe my baby is the Son of God.
Welcome to Worship with Esther. Today I'm going to be playing Silent Night on keyboard. Sing along with me.
Yeah.
Welcome back to another episode on Elijah and Abigail's Gospel Show. Today we are talking about Christmas presents, but not the presents that you receive on Christmas Day, but the presence of God with us. Abigail, can you read this verse?
John 3:16 says this, "For God loved the world so much that he gave his only son." God gave his son so that whoever believes in him may not be lost but have eternal life. Amen. I like opening presents. I like to rip them up.
The first Christmas present was wrapped in swaddling cloth and placed in a manger.
Please, can you read about it to me?
Yes. Luke chapter 2, verse 12 to 15 says this. "This is how you will know him. You'll find him, a baby, wrapped in cloth and lying in a feeding box. Then a very large group of angels from heaven joined the first angel. All the angels were praising God, saying, 'Give glory to God in heaven, and on earth let there be peace to the people who please God.' Then the angels left the shepherds and went back to heaven. The shepherds said to each other, 'Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened. We will see this thing the Lord told us about.'"
I hope you enjoy unwrapping your presents.
And I hope you enjoy the presence of God with you in your life.
Thank you for watching another episode on Elijah and Abigail's Gospel Show. And remember, trust in the Lord. Bye!
Happy Christmas!
Christmas, I'm reminded why I wanna know your love. Holy, holy, this Christmas I will sing. Holy, holy.
Everybody enjoy. Come on, say goodbye. Oh, where's Joy? Here she comes. Bye, everybody. Thank you for coming along to another episode of The Virtual Village. We'll see you next week. Thank you to the amazing team who helped put all the content together. Bye.
Welcome to Withinshaw Community Church's Christmas Day service. Let's get together and worship our Saviour on his birthday.
Not a king adorned in splendor, robed in glory, but a baby in a manger born to save. Not a warrior who fights his way to power, but a friend who faced the cross to set us free. You are with us, you are.
You are with us. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace. Hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings. Risen with healing in his wings. Mighty lays his glory by.
This is a great time to be together in the presence of the Lord, a great day to celebrate. It's an amazing day that you and I can come together and just give him praise and give him glory. It's a time of giving. And I remember Pastor Ross preaching over the last couple of weeks on the message about giving, about the wise men giving, the frankincense, the gold, and the myrrh. And they're not things that we give now, today, but we can still give. We can still give unto the Lord. We can give of our time. We can give of our treasures, and we can give of our talents. Give to the Lord the glory he deserves. Bring your offering and come into his courts and worship the Lord in his holy splendor. Let all the earth tremble before him. This is a great reason for you and I to give. It's a reason to glorify God. And this must never stop. We must never stop giving. We must never stop glorifying God, because God is a giver and he's given to us. I'm reminded of the story of the woman in the book of Matthew, chapter 26 and verses 6. And it says here, "Now while Jesus was in Bethany at the house of Simon the leper, a woman came to him with an alabaster jar of expensive perfume oil, and she poured it on his head as he was at the table. When the disciples saw this, they became indignant and said, 'Why this waste? It could have been sold at a high price and the money given to the poor.' When Jesus learned of this, he said to them, 'Why are you bothering this woman? She has done a good service for me. For you will always have the poor with you, but you will not always have me. When she poured this oil on my body, she did it to prepare me for burial. I tell you the truth, wherever this gospel is proclaimed in the whole world, what she has done will also be told in memory of her.'" We're still talking about the woman with the alabaster box. We are given of all she had to Jesus. We want to be a people that will give their time, treasure, and talents, and we can give them to the Lord, and we can glorify him in Jesus' name. God bless you.
Come, let us A very blessed Christmas to you. Today we celebrate the gift above all gifts, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us in the book of Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6,
"For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given.
And the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace."
What a great love that the God of the universe would come to this world as a baby to redeem us to himself.
So from our family to yours, we want to wish you all a happy Christmas and a prosperous New Year.
Good morning, everyone. From my family and all our church leaders here at Within Shore Community Church, we want to wish you all a very blessed and Christ-filled Christmas. I want to thank you for joining us today on Christmas Day to worship our Savior, Jesus Christ. When Jesus was born of a virgin, there were wise men. By the way, they were really wealthy and educated Gentiles who traveled a very long way from the East to worship Jesus. Now, they gave Jesus very unusual gifts, and we've been looking at those gifts in Matthew chapter 2, verses 10 to 11. Let me read it. "When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house, and they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. By the way, this is really important. They bowed down and worshipped him. And they opened their treasure chest and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Let us pray before we begin. Father, we want to thank you. We want to honor you. We want to praise you for your goodness and mercy. As we have come together today on this very special day to worship our Lord Jesus Christ, we want to pray, Father God, that you prepare our hearts, that you open our eyes, that you open our ears, Father, as we examine our lives, that you reveal things to us that we can change to become more like your Son, Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for this time that we have together. Remove all distractions. Prepare our hearts. In Jesus' name, Father, we pray. Amen and amen. Hey, the wise men brought Jesus three gifts: gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And over the last few weeks, we have been looking at the spiritual significance of these gifts. The frankincense, which we looked at last week, represents Jesus as the high priest, the representative of the people to God, as the one who would give his life and the one who would sit at the right hand of God the Father, making intercession for God's people. Jesus, our high priest. On Sunday just gone, we also looked at myrrh. And that represents Jesus as the suffering servant or the Lamb of God. Today, I want to look at the gift of gold. You see, throughout the history, because of the shortage and the value of gold, this has been known as a gift fit for a king. I want to talk to you today on Christmas Day about the kingship of Jesus Christ. Jesus as a king. The Apostle Paul said in 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 15, "For in due season, Christ will be revealed from heaven by the blessed and only Almighty God, the King of kings and the Lord of lords." Now, when the Apostle Paul said this, there is no way to say it with more emphasis. The King of kings and the Lord of lords. You see, Jesus is the supreme authority over all the kingdoms of the world. He is king like no other. You see, the Jews and the religious leaders were expecting a Messiah, a savior, a king to be born. The problem is this: they were expecting their king to be born in a palace, surrounded by wealth and luxury and comfort. You see, no one expected the king to be born in poverty in a farm next to animals. They didn't expect the Savior, the Messiah, to be the son of a carpenter born in Nazareth. I mean, even Nathanael asked this question: can anything good at all come from Nazareth? You see, no one predicted that the King of Kings, the Son of God, would bring safety to prostitutes, even touch leopards, even love those that the religious people rejected. They never imagined the king who would choose uneducated fishermen, hated tax collectors, even rebellious troublemakers to be his own disciples. No one ever imagined that a king would forgive a woman caught in the very act of adultery when the law said that she should be stoned. And yet, he would confront the hypocrisy of the Pharisees again and again and overturn the tables when the people misused his temple as a place of personal profit. They never ever imagined that the king of the Jews would ride into Jerusalem on a donkey. And those who would be cheering for his arrival would be the outcast. I mean, no one expected the king to stand a trial for crimes that he did not even commit. No one ever imagined that an innocent king would be beaten, would be whipped, would be stripped naked to hang on an instrument of torture known as the cross, dying a death of a criminal that he didn't even deserve. You see, no one ever imagined that the King of Kings on the cross, as a creator in the flesh, and as creation mocked him, spat on him, that this king, while he was suffering, he looked up in heaven and prayed for mercy for those who were torturing him. When he said, "Father, please forgive them because they don't know what they are doing." No one ever expected that the king to die a shameful death in front of the people mocking him. And when he breathed his last, There was no one predicting that the sky would go dark and that the earth would shake and that the world would lose hope as they buried a dead king in a borrowed grave. No one, and I mean no one, expected that 3 days later, when some woman went to check on the tomb, that the stones would be rolled away. You see, the body was not there. The king was risen from the dead, and he sits at the right hand of God the Almighty. And I want to tell you about the king like no other. So this is a very unusual Christmas message, because it's an incredibly unusual way for God to show his love to a broken and sinful world. What is interesting to me is when we look at this story, we can see three very distinct responses to Jesus as king. And what is really interesting is the fact that here we are 2020 years later, and we see the exact same response to Jesus as king. So today, I really want to ask you to be honest before God and really examine your response to Jesus as your king. You see, there were three different distinct responses. The first one was by King Herod. If you know this story, Herod exposed Jesus as the king. He wanted to guard and protect his kingship. So he issued a decree that all the boys under the age of 2 years old in Bethlehem will be put to death, because he heard that there might be a king who might be threatening his kingdom. So this morning, there might be those of you who might be saying, no, I don't need no religion. No, I don't need that kind of God stuff. I don't need that Jesus stuff. I'm doing fine on my own. I don't want anybody else to tell me what to do. I'm fine. And as a result, you're literally opposing, whether you know it or not, you're literally opposing Jesus as your king. You're thinking to yourself, well, I'm going to do life my way. I don't want anybody to tell me what to do. I don't let some outdated book to some religious principles to some stupid church to tell me how to live. I got this. This is my life. And I don't need no king ruling over me. So in a way, like King Herod, you're opposing Jesus as your king. You see, there was a second group. And I think this is extremely common today. The Jewish priest. They didn't oppose Jesus. They just completely dismissed him as king. They dismissed him. And this is the kind of stuff that's happening all the time. Have you ever invited a family or a friend or even a neighbor to church? Hey, do you want to go to church with me to experience the presence of God? And they'd be like, nah, thank you. I've got better things to do. Did you know that we have literally access to his powerful love letter from God that literally offers life, freedom, it offers hope? And when we offer it to a broken person and we ask them, hey, would you like to read God's love letter to you? And they'd be like, nah, I don't need that. You see, the Jewish priest do exactly what is common today. They literally just dismiss Jesus as their king. Then we have the third group, the wise men. You see, the wise men bow down and worship Jesus as their king. Their ultimate response to a reverence of awe and honor to the God of heaven who became one of us in the person of Jesus. And they say, it's not about us. It's not even about our throne or even our desires. With everything in us, we want to surrender a posture. And they bow down and they literally, in reverence of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, they bow down and worshiped him. So I want to ask you today, what is your response? Is your response, I don't need him. I got this. This is my life. I'm doing fine on my own. Are you opposing him? You might not call it that, but that's the way you live your life. That's the kind of things that you're doing. Maybe like more people around you today, you just dismiss him. Yeah, I mean, it's a great story. I mean, I did go to church when I was a kid. Or even worse, yeah, I mean, I know some people really need God, but you know me, I'm doing fine on my own. I don't need no God. I got this. And you literally just dismiss him. Or is he the king of your heart? Is he the king of your life? I want to tell you that Jesus is my king. He is my Lord. And with everything in me, I worship him. When you realize his love for you, when you open your eyes to what he has done for you, Jesus was a king who literally stripped himself of the glory of heaven, born of a virgin in poverty, reaching out to the lowest of the low. Those who were despised, let me bring it home to you today. He came for those who just can't get it right. For those who are financially a mess. For those whose first marriages didn't work. For those who are addicted and they've been trying and trying and trying, but they keep failing. For those who are trying to find meaning in all the wrong places. Going to bed literally longing for something more. Hurting and feeling empty. He came for people like that. He came for me. Listen, he loved me where I was. He didn't forgive me because I was good. No, he forgave me because he's incredibly good. And I just really want you to know him. He came for me. Listen, Jesus also came for you. Let me tell you about my king. He's not some distant king, angry, uninvolved judge wanting for you to mess up. He's not that man upstairs. He's not that big guy in the sky. He's that righteous King of Kings. He's that Lord of Lords. I would love for you to know him today. If you just don't mind today, out of the reverence of the King of Kings, who became one of us, who gave his life, would you mind just stand on your feet today? We just want to take a moment to literally prepare our hearts to worship this King, to give him glory, to give him reverence for who he is. Who is this King who gave his life for us? My King, according to the scripture, is the King of glory. He's the King of righteousness. He's the King of ages. He's the King of all kings. He is the King that heals the sick. He opens blind eyes. He heals deaf ears. He strengthens the weak. He delivers the captives. He restores those who are broken, who are hurting. He is that King. He is the shelter in your time of trouble. Listen, he is the light when your world is dark. He is that Prince of Peace, the Lamb of God. He is the Alpha and the Omega. He is the resurrection and life. And he is our King. His goodness is indescribable. His power is incomprehensible. His grace is irresistible. And his name, at his name, darkness literally trembles. In his presence, demons flee, for the devil hated him. But he couldn't stop Jesus. No, death could not defeat him. Grave could not hold him. Jesus is that King. And all I want you to know him. I really want you to know him. I want to take some moment here right now. And we want to worship our King. Come on. Can you just get up and just worship our King? Let us just worship our King.
There is a King seated among us. Let every heart receive him now. Where there is praise, he will inhabit. And there will be grace and mercy all around. Every burden will be lifted in his presence, and every trouble will be laid down at his feet. There is a name, there is above all others, Jesus Christ, the King above all kings. You are above every name. Unto the Lamb honor and glory. Worthy is he who overcame. buried in shame, but risen in power. He is alive in the storm.
some praise. Can we just worship him? Can we just shout his name? Can we shout the name of Jesus? Come on, I know we are doing online church. I know some of you are at church, some are at home, but we can still do this. There's power when we come and shout the name of Jesus. Come on, let's do this. One, two, three. Jesus! Come on, we can do better than that. Jesus! We worship you, we honor you. Jesus! Yes, come on. Lift his name. Give him praise today. Our Father, we worship you as the true King, supreme ruler of the universe. Not just some king who reigns, but a king full of love, full of grace. Not just who came to rule, but the one who came to literally die so that we could live and be in a relationship with you. Yes, he wants you to have a relationship with him. Listen, if you haven't realized today, maybe you haven't really acknowledged Jesus as your King. If you have lived your life your way, if you have lived a life centered by you, but you want to make a commitment right now on this Christmas day to make Jesus the center of your life, all it takes is literally to call on him. Do you need him? Do you need his forgiveness? Do you need his presence? Listen, I promise you, wherever you are, whether you're at home, whether you're at church, Jesus' presence is right there with you. Wherever you're watching this service, I promise you that Jesus is right there with you. What you are sensing right now is literally his goodness. He's sensing his love. We call this the gospel. That means the good news. What is the gospel? As simple as I can explain it, as simple as I can share it, God loves you so much that he sent his son, his one and only son, Jesus, born of a virgin. Why does that matter? He didn't inherit the sin nature from an earthly father, but instead, the divine nature from heavenly father. He was all God, and at the same time, he was all man, God in flesh. He was perfect in every way. He honored God with a sinless life so that he could be that innocent sacrifice. Listen, he shed his blood on that cross for the forgiveness of our sins. And oh, that's the good news. And when he gave his life, I want to tell you, he didn't just stay dead. Our God raised him from dead so that anyone, that includes you, so anyone calls on the name of Jesus, which is above every other name, that the name of our high priest, the name of our suffering servant, the name of the King that is above every other king, his name is Jesus. Yes, Jesus. When you call on his name, when you call on his name, he hears your prayers. He forgives all your sins and he makes you brand new. And if that's you and you're saying, yes, I want his forgiveness. Yes, I need his mercy. I want his presence. I felt empty and I'm searching for something. I want to tell you what you're searching for is that emptiness. That emptiness that can only be filled by Jesus. And if that's you and you want to call on him, all you have to do is call on the name of Jesus and he hears your prayer. And if you do that, he will come and he will fill that emptiness. Yes, yes, Jesus. All you have to do is just, I want to turn away from my sin. I want to become brand new. And by faith, I want to give my life. If that's your prayer, and you're just saying, I want to pray that prayer. Come on, if that's your first time, just pray this prayer right after me. Heavenly Father, forgive my sins. Jesus, save me. Be the Lord of my life. Be the King of my life. Fill me with your spirit so I can follow you, so I can worship you, so I can show your love because you have changed me. My life is not my own. I give it to you. Thank you for the new life. You have my life now. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen and amen. Hey, if you prayed this prayer for the first time and you are in church, please raise your hand and one of the leaders will come and help you with your next step. If you're online and you prayed this prayer for the first time, then there is a link in the comments area that you can click and please fill in your details and what we'll do, we'll contact you and we can help you with your next step. I want to thank you again for joining us today. And I want to pray that you have a blessed and Christ-filled Christmas. God bless you, and we'll see you on Sunday.
Please come for us.
joining us today. It was a wonderful service, and enjoy the rest of the day with your family and friends. Keep safe and keep well.
Thank you.